Okay. Hello, Clearwater Dolphins, and welcome back to CNN. And I'm your host, Allison.
And I'm your co-host, Joshua.
On Monday, there will be a yearly performance test for 3rd and 6, all the way to Wednesday.
And on Thursday, there will be a math test, 3 to 6, all the way to Friday.
And back to you in the studio.
What's up, Clearwater Dolphins? My name is Daniel.
My name is Valerie.
I'm Mrs. Roth.
And welcome back to What's Up With You.
Ms. Roth, what's up with you?
Well, as we know, we're getting ready to go towards the end of the year. So things that I'm doing right now here at school, getting ready for CAS testing, getting ready for the Olympics, and all the super fun end of the year events that we get ready to do. At home, we're wrapping up softball season and baseball season with my kids. So as much as I love to see them play and have a good time with their teams, I'm ready for it to be over. Ms. Roth. It's ready for a little break from that, so. But it's all good, all good.
What is the most worthy binge TV show?
I would say that my binge-worthy TV show that I actually, every once in a while, will take some time to watch would be the show Nailed It on Netflix. If you guys haven't watched it, it's pretty hilarious baking competition, and people try to make these crazy cakes and concoctions, and they turn out awful. It's like a Pinterest fail, but it's hilarious. And everybody just laughs about it because they know they're not that good at bakers, so it's all good, though.
Who is your favorite dead person in history?
I would definitely say that the historical figure that I probably look up most to would probably be Dr. Martin Luther King Jr., just for everything that he's contributed to our society, and just the way that he was able to get his points across without nonviolence, and just how he really helped to create a lot of change here in our country. So I would say that he's my favorite dead person in history.
Who is your favorite superhero?
My favorite superhero would definitely be Wonder Woman. I think she's very strong, and she works together with others in order to be able to help tackle those villains and to help rid the world of evil. So she's my favorite.
Well, that's all for now. Bye.
Hello, Clearwater Dolphins. My name is Autumn, and I am back with this week's weather. On Monday, it's going to be 79 degrees, partly sunny, and a thunderstorm. On Tuesday, it's going to be 83 degrees, mostly sunny. On Wednesday, it's going to be 82 degrees, times of sun and clouds. On Thursday, it's going to be 75 degrees and chance of PM showers. And on Friday, it's going to be considerable cloudiness. Stay classy, Clearwater.
Hello, Clearwater Dolphins. Welcome back to Poll Question.
Thank you to the 300 people who participated in last week's poll question.
In first place is black.
In second place is blue.
And in third place is red.
This week's poll question is, what do you like to do to prepare for CAS testing or fast bridge?
Your options are number one, go to bed early. Number two, wake up early. Number three, have a good breakfast.
Number four, be at school on time. Number five, review your notes. Or number six, do nothing. My name is Rebecca Martinez.
My name is Callie Gonzalez.
My name is Lucia Murrow. And that's all for now, Clearwater Dolphins.
Hey, Clearwater Dolphins, and welcome back to another World News. Today, the world news is our lovely dwarf planet, Pluto. In 1980, astronomers began to suspect Pluto has an atmosphere. Today, Pluto is in danger of losing its atmosphere by freezing and collapsing by 2030 due to expanded winter. Moving along, the source of the sun's plasma ray has finally been discovered. On Earth's rain, comes in water, but on the sun, it comes as plasma. It drizzles down from the atmosphere to the surface. And that's all for now.
Hello, Florida Dolphins. We are back with Guess the Disney Character.
We are going to give you some clues, and you have to figure out who we are talking about.
First clue, she wears a red bow in a red dress.
Second clue, she wears yellow shoes and she wears white gloves.
Did you get a clue yet? This week's Disney character is Minnie Mouse.
This week's Disney character is Minnie Mouse from Disney's Mickey Mouse.
That's it for this week's Guess the Disney Character.
Bye-bye, butterfly.
Hi, to our dolphins. Welcome back to True for Life.
My name is Manuel Velasquez.
And my name is Jose Gonzalez.
Today's staff member is Mr. Estes.
So is it A, Mr. Estes speaks and reads Danish?
Or is it B, Mr. Estes ate 20 Danishes at a Danish eating contest? Drum roll, please.
It's A, I speak and read in Danish. And I learned how to speak and read in Danish from my wife, who's from Denmark. And if you're wondering what my classroom country is, it's Denmark. So so that's my definitely my one of my favorite things is going to Denmark. And so definitely, yeah, I speak Danish.
That's all for now, to our dolphins. Bye.
Hello, welcome back to Famous Quote. This quote is by Louisa May Alcock, a famous author. She said, "I am not afraid of storms, for I am learning how to sail my ship." I am Allison Linda Verde. See you next time.
Clearwater Dolphins, welcome back to Artist of the Week. This week's artist is Vincent Van Gogh. When he was 13, Vincent went to secondary school in Tilburg, where he earned good marks, especially for languages. All the same, he quit the school halfway through his second academic year for unknown reasons. Vincent never went back to school. Vincent was a Dutch post-impressionist painter who is among the most famous and influential figures in the history of Western art. In just over a decade, he created about 2,100 artworks, including around 860 oil paintings, most of them in the last 2 years of his life. Born March 30th, 1853 in Sundren, Netherlands, and died July 29th, 1898 in France. That's all for now. My name is Rebecca Martinez, and see you next week on Artist of the Week.
Hello, Clearwater Dolphins, and welcome to Student Spotlight.
And today we are here with Ellen.
First question, what do you want to be when you grow up?
I want to be a professional soccer player.
Second question, who's your teacher?
Miss Bocelli, and I'm in first grade.
Third question, what is your favorite color?
Purple.
That's all for now, Clearwater Dolphins. What's up, Clear Dolphins? My name is Daniel.
And my name is Daniel. And welcome back to Joke and Riddle of the Week. And let's get on with the joke.
What is black and white and red all over?
I don't know. What?
A newspaper.
That's all for now, Clear Water Dolphins.
Hey, Clear Water Dolphins. Welcome back to this week's cartoon. This week's cartoon is Courage the Cowardly Dog.
Courage is a pink dog which is always paranoid and must overcome his fear and save his owner, Estes and Muriel.
It aired February 18, 1996 and discontinued on November 22, 2002.
Estes loves to scare Courage and tease him all over the farm.
That's all for now, Courage Dolphins. My name is Hannah.
And my name is Daniel.
Okay.
Colorado Dolphins. Welcome back to Trivia Question. This week's question is, where was the first ever Olympics? Your options are A, Greece, B, Brazil, C, USA, or D, China. If you thought A, Greece, you are correct. My name is Rebecca Martinez. See you next week on Trivia Question.
What's up, Clear Dolphins? My name is Daniel.
And my name is Daniel. And welcome back to Joke and Riddle of the Week. And let's get on with the joke.
What is black and white and red all over?
I don't know. What?
A newspaper.
That's all for now, Clear on the Dolphins.
Hey, Colorado Dolphins, welcome back to Animal of the Week. Today's animal is a pangolin. The pangolin, otherwise known as the scaly anteater, is the only mammal in the world covered head to toe with keratin scales. They inhabit tropical forests, dry woodlands, and savannas. They are eight species of pangolins. Pangolins means roller. See you next time.
Hello, Clearwater Dolphin. Welcome back to a new segment called Company of the Week. This week's company is Microsoft.
Microsoft was made by Bill Gates and Paul Allen. Also, Microsoft made a project called NatSecSeeds. It is deploying submarine data centers worldwide.
It was deployed in June 2018. Microsoft also makes Xbox One. Well, that's all for today, Clearwater Dolphins. Bye. Sony's better.
Hello, Clear Dolphins. Welcome back to Dance of the Week. This week's dance is the worm.
My name is Luis, and that's all for now.
Hello, Dolphins. Welcome back to State of the Week. My name is Caleb Schneck.
And my name is Jasmine Lopez. This week's state is Missouri. Missouri's capital is Jefferson City.
The state of Missouri was named after a tribe of Sioux Indians of the state called the Missouris.
Richland, Missouri is the only city in the U.S. with a Crave's restaurant.
The Gateway Arch in St. Louis is the tallest man-made national monument in the United States, which is in Missouri.
Missouri has been called the mother of the West and the Crave State.
Bye.
We're back.
And we have an interesting fact.
The wedding ring goes on the left finger because it's the only finger with the vein that is connected to the heart.